Hello, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Dow Corning is the largest silicone manufacturer and a major supplier of silicone-based ingredient, excipient, and API, serving the entire spectrum of the pharmaceutical industry, from consumer-chosen application to physician-prescribed Rx product. One of the main hurdles that the pharmaceutical industry is having today is the lack of innovation and differentiation, especially in the field of excipient and ingredients. And this is partially explained, in fact, by the lack of a regulatory system that encourages and approves advances in material innovation. Silicone-based ingredient, excipient, and robust formulation can help you enhancing your drug delivery system by improving both efficacy and patient compliance. And today, we'll present you our latest updates. The global healthcare industry is facing today a lot of different challenges. With a growing and an aging population, affordability and access to healthcare are the most urgent challenges we need to address. Thus, how can we encourage innovation across the whole process, from prevention to cure, to ensure that as many patients receive the right treatment at the right time and the right place? Across the world, the demand for decent and better care is increasing, whatever it is in major economies or in developing countries. An increasing overall cost of healthcare are driving payers to demand outcome or performance solution, having the implication of increasing the need for improved and proven efficacy as well as patient compliance. Overall, sustainability of the drug discovery process and total life cycle of the drug are also challenging for this industry, increasing thereby the time and the cost needed to put a product on the market. So how can we encourage innovation across the whole process, from drug discovery to market approval and acceptance? Increasing actually the collaboration across the entire spectrum of each interaction would greatly contribute towards bringing safe and efficacious medication to the patients. From regulators to payers to pharma companies to suppliers, this collaboration would accelerate the entire process of bringing innovative treatments safely to the market, thus reducing cost and allowing new choices. So, how can we be more creative and patient-centric in the field of drug delivery? Dow Corning actually is concentrating its effort on two main fields: efficacy and patient compliance. Offering innovative materials and formulation assistance that can modify the drug delivery properties of your API can help you to adapt your formulation to be either more efficient or more cost effective. And we will present you one case study today. Offering choices to the patient and those who pay in such a way that physicians can choose the appropriate drug in a patient acceptable forms that guarantees the compliance to the treatment is also key. Offering silicone-based solution that help to avoid unwanted side effect, unpleasant sensory sensation, or patient unfriendly effect during the total period of the treatment will favor such a compliance. Example in both topical and transdermal field will be presented today. Indeed, in some chronic application, like the treatment of psoriasis, non-compliance to the treatment is a major issue. Dog Earning did sponsor a survey amongst more than 250 patients topically treated for the disease of psoriasis. And amongst those patients, 70% treated topically are or were not compliant. An in-depth analysis has demonstrated that there was a significant correlation between the non-adherence to the treatment and the aesthetic of the product, as well as the ease of use. The other criteria which was also evidenced here is actually the trust in the treatment as well as its effectiveness. Generally, patients are getting frustrated with their treatment and just stop it. Thereby, as a formulator of topically applied API, you also need to be sure that the patient is effectively treated with new and appealing forms that are non-oily, non-greasy, and easy to apply. Silicone technology can really make a step change in improving the aesthetics of your pharmaceutical formulation. We are today proposing you 5 different formulations here, from emulsion, gel, and ointment, with different occlusivity profile and different sensory profile. All those formulations were formulated with pharmaceutical grade excipient. And if aesthetics is really a key criteria to bring you a differentiation in this field, drug delivery is actually mandatory. So you need to deliver the drug. So all those formulations were tested not, not only for their aesthetics profile, but also for their drug delivery profile. And they were proven by in vitro tested to be as efficient as the commercial benchmark, and this for different drug models, like betamethasone dipropionate, lidocaine, and caffeine. So we did develop those different prototype formulations, and if you are more interested in knowing more about those formulations, please come and visit us at our booth, because we have a lot of information that explain the profile of those formulations, both in terms of occlusivity, substantivity, sensorial benefit, but also drug delivery profile. Drug delivery system that can effectively and efficiently utilize the loaded drug are also very much desired. And pain management treatment also prefer an early onset of patient relief. Did you know that topical treatment based on ibuprofen are commercialized almost everywhere in the world, but not in North America? Are you looking for a new topical drug delivery system and technology to help you to enhance the delivery of your active? So Dog Earning recently developed a prototype of a semi-solid formulation based on a cross-linked polymer network that actually not only shows a burst effect in the delivery of ibuprofen, but also a very different drug delivery profile compared to the hydroalcoholic-based European benchmark. So this formulation delivers ibuprofen more effectively, and more ibuprofen was delivered for a longer period of time. So this proof of concept is currently being further evaluated using other APIs. And based on current results, there are strong evidences that exist to show that our cross-link polymer silicone network provides a promising platform, technology platform actually, to improve and enhance the delivery of pharmaceutical across the skin. Dog Earning is actually also very much active in the field of transdermal drug delivery patch as a supplier of adhesive for fixation to the skin and control delivery of APIs. Our large range of pressure-sensitive adhesive has actually tunable characteristics to offer you the best solution to fit with your drug choice and your expected adhesion profile, and this in a variety of different solvents. Silicone-based transdermal drug delivery systems addresses both efficacy and compliance simultaneously, while having a skin compatibility profile which is largely recognized by main pharmaceutical players that are active into that field. Critical parameters are to secure the patch adhesion and efficiently stabilize and release your drug. When comparing the different adhesive system here, silicone, acrylic PIB, actually, the silicone-based solutions are generally recognized as providing a very good drug release profile here, while the acrylic-based system actually are known for their broad drug solubility panel. So you can see that both profiles are slightly different. So there were some attempts to mix silicone and organic, which is acrylic blends actually, in order to combine both the benefit of silicone and acrylic. But those blends, even if they profile, then if they provide now a very good drug release profile and a good drug solubility, they have a poor phase stability. They are not very stable actually. So Dow Corning today is introducing a hybrid solution, a silicone acrylate hybrid transdermal system that is showing a good release profile with an expanded drug solubility when compared to the silicone adhesive alone, while providing this good phase stability. So would you be more interested in knowing about this technology, which is available as samples? You need to come and visit it at our booth. And there is a poster or a paper which is explaining you the technology and this aspect of phase stability. In addition to silicone-based ingredient and excipient for drug delivery system, Dow Corning also offers silicone-based API for gastroenterology. Being the center of your body, the gastrointestinal system is highly organized and sensitive network to different organs. With less time to eat and a diet regime and nutrition which is changing across the world, and not always for the better, I'm afraid, more and more people are suffering from stomach pain, heat burns, dyspepsia, gas, and constipation. Cimeticone have a long history of safety and efficacy for their use in anti-acid and anti-gas products. While cimeticone compounds are generally used in products like soft gel capsules, silicone emulsion are actually suitable for water-based systems. Dow Corning is today introducing a new silicone-based emulsion based on a vegetable surfactant. This emulsion is very convenient for use in aqueous-based system and easily formulated in your pharmaceutical product. Our silicone-based API are tested and certified to meet the requirement of the US and European Pharmacopeia for cimeticone, and to ensure a consistent quality for use in pharmaceutical application, Dow Corning cimeticone are produced, packaged, and tested at our dedicated healthcare industry material site, certified by the FDA, utilizing the US FDA GMP guidelines for active pharmaceutical ingredients. So the dog warning team is available at our booth for more in-depth discussion on the different topics that I have highlighted into that presentation and that are of interest to you. So our experts in different fields are ready to welcome you and provide you with more details on how silicone-based technologies may help you to design your future drug delivery system and address the key challenges of those drug delivery systems. So come and visit us at the booth 31B06, and all our experts will welcome you and we'll see, we'll talk together in order to see what we can do for you. So thank you for your attention, and thank you for your time this afternoon, and all the questions are welcome. The question is actually if we are targeting new API in the field of topical excipient or gastroenterology. In the field of topical excipient, we actually are commercializing excipient and ingredients. So excipient for the development of pharmaceutical application and ingredients for the development of consumer healthcare applications. So they are not considered as being API per se, but we are really putting a lot of effort to put all the regulatory stuff behind our excipient at a point which is close to what would be expected in API. So you know that regulation is becoming more and more demanding on the excipient. And actually, we have here our regulatory expert in the name of Patricia Rafidison, who can help you if you have any question and you come at our booth and you ask for a meeting with her. She is very knowledgeable. So that's for topical. And for API in gastroenterology, basically, we are having two form of product, an emulsion and a compounds. Actually, several products are being proposed depending on your requirement from a formulation standpoint, viscosity of your product, stability of your product, and all that stuff. So we have several forms, but we don't have the intention to create a new API. So our core technology is silicone and cimeticone for the API, and we'll stick with what is our core business.
I suppose the question comes, if certain companies work with certain APIs, mm-hmm. they need to understand the chemistry from the respects of polar, non-polar, soluble, insoluble, products that it doesn't work with, in order to further investigate those APIs that perhaps they specialise in that they see application for. Yeah. So I know Dow Corning in the cosmetic and beauty side has a list of all the compatibilities and polar, yeah. non-polar. So it's very easy to determine whether a particular API may work in the delivery system or not. So it's more to help other customers mm-hmm. with different APIs.
Yeah, exactly, and this is a very good point. And actually, we are also doing and generating this type of information of all the compatibility profile. For the time being, it's basically how silicone technology are compatible with some of the organic excipient, because it's very difficult to do a 100% base silicone formulation. So an organic excipient that are well known into the pharmaceutical industry are also very much valuable to bring you the right formulation and the right drug delivery system. So we are providing all those compatibility profiles with organic excipient, and we are building really a database with different API. You saw here that we are in model drugs with lidocaine, caffeine, and betamethasone dipropionate. We also worked on ibuprofen, but we also worked on ketoprofen, for example, different pain management active, different active into the treatment of psoriasis, because it's not only betamethasone, but you may have calcipotriol also, which is of interest. So we are building this database in all the application where we believe that silicon can really bring a point of difference, like in terms of drug delivery or in terms of aesthetics. You know, people that are suffering for psoriasis, they really have a problem with what is on the market because it's too oily, too heavy, and they stop their treatment. And there is a big, big problem of compliance. So we believe that really there, silicone can make a big difference.
Merci.
You're welcome.